there, viewers, and welcome back to the Bestie Zone. When you think of acidic foods, citrus, hot sauce, and acid reflux probably come to mind. But really, acidic foods are important for your body. Too many, however, might cause some problems. That's why it's important for you to know what you're eating and if your diet is out of balance. Today, we're going to highlight some of the most acidic foods so you can gauge if you're eating too much or too little. Is ice cream considered acidic? What's homeostasis? Wait, lemons aren't actually an acidic food? We're gonna answer all these important questions and we'll tell you some of the best foods to get your body balanced at the end. What foods do you love but have to avoid? Let us know quickly in the comments section below. Acid-forming foods versus acidic pH. Okay, so before we start listing foods, we gotta get one thing out of the way. And that is, what do we mean when we say acidic? Because it sorta has two meanings. So the way in which we measure how acidic or alkaline something is through the pH scale. Anything from 1 to 6 is acidic, and anything from 7 to 14 is considered alkaline. If you've ever made a volcano for science class, then you know what we're talking about. When an acid, like vinegar, combines with baking soda, an alkaline, they form a reaction. Now, this reaction isn't going to happen in your body, but it's a good way of illustrating the power pH levels have in the environment. Just because something is acidic, let's say a lemon, it doesn't mean it has the ability to create an acidic environment once ingested. For example, lemons are acidic on the pH scale. However, once your body digests that lemon, it becomes very alkaline and helps to balance the body. But why does this matter? Well, our bodies fall around the middle of the pH scale, that is to say we're slightly alkaline, falling in and around 7.35 to 7.45 pH. Keeping your body in a neutral pH state, around a 7, keeps your energy levels up and allows the oxygen in your blood to get where it needs to go. It can also harm the liver and prevent it from properly detoxifying your body. Acidic blood can also harm bone density and could up your risk of cancer. Unfortunately, a lot of the foods we eat fall under the acidic scale, and that'll interrupt the important homeostasis or balance our bodies need. Confusing, right? Well, there's so many more foods that seem either acidic or alkaline but aren't. But don't worry, we've got you covered. Let's get to the list. Number 1. Red meat. This one includes processed meats as well, so those hot dogs you packed away all summer might be catching up with you in more ways than one. Unfortunately, processed meats include cured ham and bacon, beef jerky, smoked and canned meat. Basically, anything that's been cured, smoked, dried, salted, or canned falls under this category. Other animal products like chicken are foods to be mindful of when considering the acidic levels. Red and processed meats are acidic-producing foods, so while they may fall on the alkaline side of the pH scale, once ingested, they produce acid in the body. Not to mention, processed meats may up your risk for chronic diseases like COPD, heart disease, high blood pressure, and certain forms of cancer. Number 2. Eggs. We might as well lump this in with the animal products like meat we just talked about because, unfortunately, eggs fall under the acidic category once you eat them. That being said, eggs are highly nutritious, and if incorporated into a balanced diet with lots of fruits and vegetables, will probably benefit you more than harm you. If you're eating a lot of foods on this list and haven't had a salad in a month, you might want to cut back. Number 3. Soda. Refined sugar in general is pretty bad for your health. If you're trying to eat better, then sugary drinks and foods should be the first to go. Sugary drinks in particular are damaging to your health because your body doesn't realize how much sugar it's ingesting. It sort of tricks it. You don't feel full after drinking a glass of juice or a sugary latte. When you consume these liquid sugars, you'll probably consume way more calories than you would if you were eating. That's just with weight loss. If you drink soda on the regular, then you're at a much higher risk of prediabetes, kidney issues, and decreased bone density. Diet soda isn't much better, so if you can, try limiting yourself or drink more water in between cans of soda. Number 4. Dairy. This would be the last type of food I would think to be acidic. Maybe milk isn't the answer when it comes to heartburn. Not ice cream too, I'm afraid so. Cheese, milk, ice cream, all of these are high in phosphorus, which means once you ingest them, it turns acidic. Again, if you can't remember the last time you ate a salad and you had ice cream, milk, or cheese every day this week, you might want to try and balance out some of that acidity. Number 5. Processed grains. Fresh baked bread is one of the best smells on the planet, but that doesn't mean it's good for us. Processed foods like baked goods and fluffy white bread are not really that good for us in general, even though they're delicious. Bread is hard to digest on a good day and causes inflammation in the body, which we know is bad. This is another food that, once eaten, turns acidic and can up your overall pH levels. Anything in moderation is probably okay, so if you wanted donuts for your 40th birthday party, go ahead. Just make sure you slip in a few salads and add some extra fruit on your oatmeal leading up to your special day. Number 6. Alcohol. Okay, yup, you knew this was going to be on our list. It's true, alcohol is highly acidifying once ingested. Not to mention if you have issues like GERD or acid reflux, drinking will only exacerbate the problem further. Besides raising your level of acidity, heavy drinking has been linked to upping your risk of cancer. So, with that in mind, it's recommended adult women have no more than one drink per day and that men have no more than two a day. This is summed up as moderate drinking. If you avoid drinking altogether, you're actively lowering your risk of cancer down the road. But if you're partaking in the fun a little too often, you're probably doing the opposite. Number 7. Legumes and unsprouted beans. These are probably the least offending food on the list, but we had to throw them in. When you eat certain acid-forming foods like legumes and unsprouted beans, they leave a chemical substance behind known as ash in the medical community. This is what actually turns either acidic or alkaline depending on what you just ingested. That residue is what changes the pH in the blood, raising the acidity levels. Legumes are pretty good for you in general, but if you're piling this kind of food on top of a strictly fast food and processed food diet, you may want to skip them next time. Number 8. Nuts. It's true, this is another one that usually falls into the healthy category. When it comes to their acid levels, they sort of fall around the middle, so they're not the worst thing you could eat. They're a better source of protein than animal products and will be less acid-forming, so if you're stuck with a choice, snack on some nuts instead of that burger. Number 9. Coffee. Yes, we're afraid so. Coffee is acidic any way you slice it, pH-wise and acid-forming-wise. Some forms will be worse than others, but the acid-forming effect will be similar. Again, coffee does have a few health benefits, so if you drink it in moderation, paired with a healthy diet, you don't have to cut it out completely. But if you're a 4 cups of coffee kind of gal, the acid levels will rise in your blood and your body compensates by draining alkaline materials like calcium from your bones, trying to balance you out. Afterwards, you'll just flush all that precious calcium out when you use the bathroom. What a waste. Do you drink coffee every day? Then check out this video titled Drinking Coffee Every Day Does This to Your Body to find out the effects. Okay, so that list was kind of a bummer. Here's some foods you can have that'll balance out all the acidity in your daily diet. Basically any vegetable. Leafy greens, carrots, broccoli, mushrooms, you name it. Vegetables hold the key to longevity, and making them part of your daily meals will pay dividends in the end. Try adding veggies to your smoothies and curries if you're just starting out. Soon you'll be eating them raw as a snack because they make your body feel amazing. The only veggies we recommend avoiding are corn, olives, winter squash, and lentils. Fruit. Okay, now this is a good sign. Fruit is delicious and super versatile. This one's easy because fruit is delicious to snack on any time of the day. Try to avoid fruit juices because you're just getting 100% of the sugar, including added sugar, and 0% of the fiber. Some fruits that score extra high on our health meter are avocados, watermelon, berries, especially blueberries, lemons, and sour cherries. What's your favorite acidic food? Could you ever give it up? Let us know in the comment section below. We'd love to hear from you. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie are we if we don't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.